Le pacte vert a engagé l'agriculture européenne dans la bonne direction. On avait un projet européen qui consistait à développer l'agriculture biologique en Europe, mais aussi et surtout à baisser de 50% l'utilisation des pesticides de synthèse.
As of 2024, we really saw a shift in priority, not per se in transitioning towards more sustainable food systems, but rather in looking at the economics.
Il y a une vraie méconnaissance des méthodes de l'agriculture biologique basée sur le respect des sols, l'utilisation de la biodiversité.
What is less known is probably the social benefits of organic farm and also the economic benefits. Should the food be sustainable, affordable, healthy? Of course, and organic can provide a solution to that.
Les semences sont un maillon indispensable de la chaîne de production. Avec l'avènement de l'agriculture industrielle après la Deuxième Guerre mondiale, la sélection variétale s'est orientée dans une direction qui consiste à développer des semences qui sont aussi productives que possible, mais dans le contexte d'une agriculture à haut intrant.
Industrial breeding takes into account that a plant will receive fertilizer, it will receive pest control, it will receive herbicide. It just needs to have yield and homogeneity. And the rest you will protect with chemistry. Organic breeding looks at the plant and tries to figure out what works best in the situation on the field. So that's a different approach. The plant needs to be able to handle more differences, temperature, drought, but also microbes and insects.
I always call it a robustness of a plant. It's always good when it's too dry, it still grows. When it's too wet, it still grows. The first thing we have to do is talk with growers. What do we grow? What's your problem in there? And how can we improve this? And for instance, that's then maybe a nematode resistance in pepper.
A nematode is a small worm that grows in the soil, but it eats from your root and it lays its eggs in there, and then your plant slows down in growth, and even it can kill the whole plant in the end. We went to search for genetical material, and we also came to the INRA in France, who had done some research on nematodes also. We did a lot of tests here in his soil with his nematodes, and from there we made selections, we made crossings, so we made two hybrids, and one of them is now here, the Skyborn, in the field.
We use the rootstocks and the cultivars. With the cultivars we choose for the taste, the production and the quality, and for the rootstock we choose for what is the strongest one, but also against nematode, verticillium, fusarium.
For a good and resilient system, you need plants that can have more different circumstances and still grow.
Resistance, as it is now, is mostly based on one biological action. You can kill the pathogen, or you can keep the insect away. And you will understand if it's a single thing, then the pathogen will find a way around it. Resilience means that maybe you have these resistance genes, but there's other traits that you have that allow you to cope with different situations.
Apfelgut is an organization for the development and doing organic apple and pear breeding.
We try to work on polygenic resistances. We grow into the soil from the beginning. We try to give our seedlings a chance to adapt to environmental conditions.
Die modernen Sorten, die es für den Tafelobstbau zur Verfügung sind, dass die sehr krankheitsanfällig sind. Aber es gibt viele alte Sorten, die über die Jahrzehnte, Jahrhunderte angebaut werden, die keinen Schorf bekommen. Wo wir wissen, zum Beispiel der Seestermüller Zitronenapfel ist eine sehr, sehr robuste Apfelsorte. Wir haben entschieden, diesen Apfel mit verschiedenen modernen Sorten zu kreuzen, von denen wir wissen, dass sie die Farbe haben, den Ertrag. Und aus dieser Kreuzung ist jetzt eine Zuchtnummer entstanden, wo der Baum über die Jahrzehnte keinen Schorf, keinen Mehltau oder wenig Mehltau und wenig Obstbaumkrebs.
We have now this very aromatic, a little bit sour apple, looking really nice, but also a little bit russeted. So that's our second apple, which we have now in the development for the market, for the direct market. So this is the first trial stage, let's say. We have a very robust variety here, which can get a little bit of scab and a little bit of canker, but under an economic valuable level.
Apfelgutverein ist gemeinnützig.
We already know that if we publish a variety, it will be possible for everyone to grow it.
C'est un vrai trésor européen, cette richesse de la production semencière, cette diversité qu'on a absolument besoin de sauvegarder et de protéger contre les OGM et contre les brevets sur le vivant. Le grand intérêt des OGM pour les firmes qui les commercialisent, c'est justement d'avoir légitimé des droits de propriété intellectuelle très forts tels que les brevets qui bloquent la circulation des ressources génétiques et qui leur permettent véritablement de s'accaparer les semences mondiales à leur profit.
We say, as an organic company, we don't want any patents on our crops. Look at it this way, you find something in the wild, from a gene bank maybe, or just in the wild, there's a resistance in there, and you say, well, that's mine, it's just in nature. And I think nature is from everybody, and you cannot own it.
The big promises that entities and so on bring with it, they're fake. It's a big risk, risking that these single resistances break down after just a few years, then we lose these few resistance possibilities we might have.
If you would have one line of defense, so you make a plant species that produces a certain volatile to keep away the insect, it will work for 1 year. Because then the insect will have learned, oh yeah, this is a nasty smell, but the tomato still tastes good.
I'm going to be seated in there and I will just ask you the questions.
Innovation is often seen as something high-tech or AI or something like that. Innovation can very much be also just focusing on thinking how we can make our food system more resilient and looking at local adaptation. I started working on the live seeding project when I started working at IFOM Organics Europe around 3 years ago. It's 17 different crops, and then both in the vegetables and arable and fodder crops. So that can be tomatoes or carrots or wheat or barley or rice. So we work with case studies where breeders are focusing on a certain crop and together with farmers, so there's more like this participatory breeding approach. I think the project is really helping to bring these stakeholders together and have knowledge exchange and have exchanges about what works, what doesn't work.
Il est fondamental pour sauvegarder la souveraineté alimentaire de l'Union européenne, de protéger les semences. On a besoin d'un cadre législatif qui autorise les agriculteurs à utiliser de la biodiversité dans leurs champs et à utiliser des semences, des variétés ou du matériel hétérogène, comme on dit, qui soient justement beaucoup plus divers d'un point de vue génétique.